चले शुरू करें, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट उधम सिंह।
The research and to create the era of this film Sardar Udham was really, really tough and challenging. That when you're doing a period film and when you are creating 1919 and 1920 and 1930s, you are literally creating everything. So I've been on this subject for almost like 20-21 years. So I've read each and every possibly book, every article, every essay, everything possibly I have read. I went through mostly the statements by the survivors. So that helped me a lot.
Yeah, so the first segment was Amritsar, and we actually started off with Jallianwala Bagh. If you go down to certain old lanes now also in Amritsar, they still retain those. The typical wooden balconies which are there. So those are the things that we had to really look into when we were creating the whole era.
Cars also we got them from Patiala and Ludhiana, because there are many cars which are still available in Punjab which are from that particular era, of some cars of Rajas and Maharajas. Some cars are still there with some particular people, museum, who has still kept it as a treasure. So we requested and got them there. I was really nervous in terms of how will I create this Jallianwala Bagh, you know, that space where I find.
And as you know, Jallianwala Bagh was under renovation, which has just come out, so there was no chance we could have shot over there. Then we had to go through a lot of old images and everything, how exactly the old Jallianwala Bagh looked like.
So my friend Shubhendu and my EP suggested to see it in Amritsar and around, and also the kind of faces and people will get. When Shubhendu and Kumar showed me this particular location where we shot this, so we got this school called Gyan Ashram.
We took this whole ground, we made a whole base of the film over there. It was a school.
You won't believe, I was so happy. I was, okay, no, this is Jallianwala Bagh location, yes.
Action!
I thank the entire people of Amritsar for welcoming us with open hand.
In terms of location and identification of the location of Jallianwala, there are two, three things. Of course, the brick walls, that particular iron gate, little small temple at the corner, and there was a well. We didn't have the well, so we actually dug the well there. We recreated. You see that the mention of the well is there because a lot of people died there.
And the most important was we made dead bodies. We made 200 dead bodies. And again, with more detail of Sujitda, he was very specific the color of the blood.
So I think we must have used at least almost 1,000 liters of blood, maybe more, no less. So everywhere around, it was nothing else. There was no water body, it was purely blood. I needed to recreate this event the way it is. In terms of casting of the characters and the faces, that was very, very important for us. So we requested Makranaji, don't get people's particular faces from the city even. So he said then we'll have to go to the villages.
ऐसे अलग अलग गाँव में से लोग हमने ढूंढ ढूंढ के लाए हैं जो क्राउड या जूनियर आर्टिस्ट के लिए थे, तो वो भी एक वैल्यू रखते हैं.
There's a martial art group every Gurdwara is associated with. They are known as Gatkas. So what they do is they have children 6 year old to say at least 40 or 50 year old. They perform martial arts. They go from village to village and they perform. So we wanted those Gatka people to come, and they just came with us. Without them, I would have been really handicapped in terms of recreating that Jallianwala event. There's a certain kind of a requirement that I was looking for, especially even the British force people, because the people who were firing were actually from the Gorkha unit of the British at that time.
Abhi koi doubt hai kisi ko?
No sir.
Many jamming sessions, how to create this realistic kind of wounds, and then the body skin types was a match, because what the Europe they got, sometimes they get their skin type but they didn't match with our skin type. Those were absolutely matched with our skin types,
because this film is all real about which has happened, and that's the reason he has created all those things without any CG or anything.
Action is not about flying or going away. It was quite raw. So, it was just purely running, stampede and bullet hits.
Fire!
being in Jallianwala Bagh, between an action and cut, and I would see those bodies around me, I would freeze. Because not as an actor, not as a human being, I was prepared for something like that.
The research part was one of my favorite, going through so many beautiful pictures of a certain time period. Even following that, even for the Jallianwala Bagh, there were a lot of whites, the clothes were aged. The aging process is a very technical, long process, and we had a lot of people to get ready every day. Sometimes 4 o'clock, sometimes 5 o'clock. That was itself a big challenge for us.
So London also we went. We did a lot of research over there to find out outskirts of London to see if we can recreate that era.
I have never been to London. I have seen London through pictures, and especially all the cinemas also, all the films that's been shot on that era. We took this as a reference point.
Because today there are so many modern elements, road signages, road paintings. Those were not there in those days. So these were certain things that were taken into account. So what happened is, at least the basic architecture is still the old architecture. Then the newer elements had to be removed to make sure that it is of that period.
Because, you know, the wall design, the streets and everything, and of course we would prop it up with those London taxis and London buses of that era. We are used to a very Indian winter, which is probably 0 degrees, 1 degrees, 2 degrees. And here I was in minus 5, which is feeling like minus 20.
That moment, I was not thinking of what I'm going to shoot. I was thinking, how will I handle the cold? It was not cold, it was freezing cold, bone chilling cold.
It was really challenging for actors to be in a shirt, to be in a blazer, to be just without extra layers. You know, some places we did have overcoats, but sometimes there was a scene when we couldn't use an overcoat. A certain continuity, a certain movement. So it was really challenging.
I don't think so. Any of us will forget this experience.
When everybody forms in those small areas of their artistic vision, then that we can create that realism, that organic, realistic, that cinema, which is more mythical in nature, you know. So I think that art we can achieve.
Plastic, stand by.